From the News Channel 5 Network, this is Inside Politics.
Hello, everyone. I'm News Channel 5's political analyst, Pat Nolan. Welcome to Inside Politics. For almost a decade now, Nashville has been known as the It City. It's a phrase that's both a compliment and a pejorative term to describe our town. What does It City mean, and how did we earn that title? Our guest today is Steve Hirsch. He's compiled a book that looks at how the It City designation came to be and the forces of growth and change that have and are still driving our community. His book is entitled Greetings from Nashville, How a Sleepy Southern Town Became It City. Steve, welcome to the program.
Thanks for having me.
So why did you decide to put a book together on this topic?
The short answer is that I was working at Parnassus Books, and again and again, people would come in and ask for a book that not only did we not have, but didn't exist. And one gentleman in particular, I remember, was visiting from Chicago, which is where I grew up, and he said, I visited Nashville in the 80s, and it just seemed like this tiny little place, and look at it now. I'd love to know what happened. And he wanted a book that sort of explained this growth, and so many of the conversations I was having with people that I knew and people in the community were also sort of getting at those questions, and so that's kind of how the idea for the book was born.
When you first came here in 2003, you did some work for a while for The Scene, mm-hmm. As an editor. What made you decide to come here?
Well, it's a tale as old as time. My partner at the time, who is still my partner now, came here for school. And I had never set foot in Nashville before that. I didn't really know what to expect, but I figured, hey, I can live anywhere for 4 years, right?
Is it what you expected?
No. I mean, in many ways, I wasn't sure what to expect. Like I said, I had never been here before. And really, all I knew about Nashville was Johnny Cash and sort of related themes, you know?
In addition to working for The Scene and also being at Parnassus Books, you're now the producer of the new program at WPLN Nashville Public Radio, This is Nashville. It airs
right.
Monday through Friday at noon every day. Because of all the things that you've done, do you feel like you've now been here about 20 years, that you've got a pretty good feel for the city's most recent history and on the pulse of what's going on in the city right now?
Yeah, I feel like I have a good sense of that. You know, I think, like anyone who lives here, you know, you sort of end up in your own circles. What's great about the show is it has really gotten me out of those circles. Our executive producer, Andrea Tudhope, from the beginning has said, you know, you can't sit behind your desk and know what's going on in the city. So we've done a lot of just getting out and just talking to folks and asking them what they want from the show. And in turn, you know, that has really sort of widened my view of how people are feeling about where we are as a city.
Now, it was 2013, I think, when Nashville first got the moniker of It City. Mm-hmm. It came out of a New York Times article.
Yeah.
Where did it come from, and why did that particular author decide to give it that name?
Yeah, I don't know for sure why she chose, or Kim Severson chose that phrase exactly, but it was just, Nashville was appearing in all of these national publications. We just sort of had this shine on us at that moment. If you were here, I'm sure, you know, you remember that moment. If you weren't here, I mean, all of a sudden it seemed like everyone was mentioning us. Everyone was saying, you got to check this out. It's not what you expect. And as much as we sort of maybe found that a little irritating sometimes as locals of sort of like parachute journalism or whatever, I just think something about that moment, we were really in the spotlight in a way we hadn't been. And Kim Severson really understood that sort of like the plates were shifting here.
As I mentioned in the show opening, being the It City has been given to Nashville both as a compliment and I think in recent years more of a pejorative term.
Yeah.
Which way do you look at it, or is it both?
At this point, I think it's sort of inescapably both. You know, I think that a lot of people that I know are really tired of it, but it's really hard to avoid using it, even if you're using it sarcastically, because it is sort of this mark that we have to measure ourselves against, whether positively or negatively. So I think when people are critical of the way the city is growing, they're like, well, I guess we're the It City, but if we are, then why aren't we also doing these other things?
Your book's not a history, but with any kind of hard, fast timeline, but mm-hmm. you did kind of pick 1998 as the year that it started. Why did you pick that year?
I mean, sort of the most obvious reason, I mean, Marshall Chapman mentioned this many years ago, 98 is the year we get major league sports, right? We get the Preds, we get the Titans. And so, like, in the most obvious sense, like, 98 is this big leap forward for the city. And then so when I started looking at 98, though, I realized all these other sort of things happened around that time as well. It's also the year of the tornado in East Nashville that really begins the redevelopment of that part of town. And there's all these sort of other things that don't seem that significant necessarily in 98, but looking back, we can see that they are.
Going back to the professional sports coming to town, and we're on the threshold of deciding for a city as to whether we're going to build a new $2.2 billion retractable roof dome stadium for the Titans, and it would be used for other things, perhaps we get a Final Four and things like that. So are we reaching another critical inflection point for our city?
I think we are. I mean, it's hard to know. It's hard to know if we're even beyond the point of inflection, an inflection point. It seems like one after another, right? And
they're coming so fast.
Yeah, yeah. One thing after another. In a way that, you know, I don't think we're going to know for a while what the actual inflection point is. But it's funny. I don't know if you saw this on Twitter. People were joking that, you know, The Titans ownership was like, look, the stadium is terrible when they want a new stadium, but when they're in the World Cup bid, they're like, look, our stadium is great. You know, in some ways as a city, we're still trying to have it both ways. But I do think that stadium, I think the other sort of big developments that are coming very soon are really gonna reshape the city pretty dramatically.
We'll talk about some of those as we go on the showground. 1998 was also the beginning in the music business when it saw some tremendous changes. I think you mentioned particularly the death of Owen Bradley, mm-hmm. on the old line, old guard. People were concerned a few years ago that the music industry was changing in ways they didn't like. They've also seen a time when Branson was here and people thought they were going to take all the live music up there. That didn't happen, but there are concerns after what happened with the pandemic that live music is going to go away in Nashville. The music industry is a big part of it. We're continuing to see a lot of change.
Yeah, yeah. I think there's a lot to talk about there. In particular, I think that the pandemic was so hard on independent music venues. And I think a big struggle right now that we're seeing in the city is how are these independent venues going to survive when the cost of real estate is going up. A lot of them aren't in control of the property that they're on. And, you know, the big corporate players see Nashville as a much bigger market than they once did.
Steve Arush is our guest. He's an author of a new book, actually a compiler of a new book called Welcome to the New Nashville. Well, Greetings from the New Nashville, How a Sleepy Southern Town Became the It City. We're going to talk about his book and the It City itself after this break.